Hi, suppose there are 50 viewers, including you, watching this video right now. Let's play a game. You start with $100 and toss a fair coin. If you get ahead, your money will increase by 60%. Otherwise, your money will decrease by 50%. However, the game has a broke mechanism. If your money drops to $10 or below, you will go broke and cannot play the following round. On average, each round, your money is expected to increase by 6% minus 50% divided by 2, 5%. It is a game in your favor. Let's play the game for 30 rounds. Since the game has a positive expectation, I would expect that most of you, or even all of you, will end the game with more money. I have 50 cute icons to represent each player. You can pick anyone to represent yourself. I will first run a simulation for the coin toss, using the first icon to represent myself. If my wealth is less than $100, the color turns red. If my wealth stays above $100, it turns green. If I go broke, the color goes gray and stays gray for the rest of the game. To show you I'm not cheating, here is a key part of the simulation code. Now, if you are watching on a computer, move your mouse to your representative so you can track the performance. Are you ready? Let's go! How did you do? I hope you did well. However, I just counted. Only 6 out of 50 stay green. Almost 80% of players are out of the game. Perhaps this is just bad luck. Let's try again. This time, about 70% are broke after 30 rounds. Finally, let's play once again. I will show 3 statistical measurements: the average, the median, and the mode. Roughly speaking, the median is a value lower than the wealth of the top half, but higher than the bottom half. The mode is a value with most occurrences. The statistical measurements allow us to peek into the nature of the game. If we only look at the average, it seems that the game is indeed a rewarding game for all of you. When I say for all of you, I mean all 50 of you as a whole. However, getting rich is not a typical experience for my lovely viewer, you. I mean the one looking at the screen right now. How is it possible? And what is the mathematical implication here? To understand what's going on, we need the exact distribution of the wealth. I prepared some pseudo-histogram plot. Because the x-axis is in the logarithmic scale, I set each bin as a single line segment to avoid confusion. I'm also expanding the number of players to 5,000, so the random noise is lower. We need to find out that why mode and median remain low while average goes to the moon. The first suspicious behavior is the extremely small mode. Because of the broke mechanism, once a player's wealth drops below $10, it stays there. Broke state is like a black hole, absorbing players. This broke mechanism has a huge impact on the mode and the median. In mathematics, a single player's trajectory can be modeled as a one-dimensional random walk. I'm using a mouse to represent the player's wealth, and at any point, the mouse can go left or right with equal probability. Remember, once the mouse wanders across the broke point, there is no going back. So a player will almost surely go broke. It's just a matter of time. Here is an accelerated simulation in which all 5,000 players go broke after about 250 rounds. I created another video for a quick proof for those who are interested. So let's drop the Brook mechanism and see whether this fixes our game. In this simulation, there is no Brook point. The players can theoretically come back with any money left. Unfortunately, the answer is no. Although we have a much more symmetric distribution, but the median and the mode still sink while the average keeps going up for a short period of time. If you ever invested in a stock market, you must know that 60% up is not enough to cancel a 50% down. We need 200% up. Changing to a geometric average, the original game immediately becomes a bad game. Geometric average is more suitable for the multiplicative game. This can also be seen in the mouse movement. Watch the mouse step carefully. The step to the left is slightly larger than the step to the right. We just had a shift of perspective, did you notice? When we use arithmetic average, we are evaluating the game from a group or ensemble perspective. Namely, what will happen if a lot of people play the game together? We can call the arithmetic average the ensemble average. On the other hand, when we use the geometric average, we are evaluating the game from a time perspective. Namely, what the expectation is if a single person plays this game for a long time. I'm showing the averages of a single timeline's realization. It's like the multiverse. Across the multiverse, something good happens, but in your specific timeline, you may end up with a terrible realization. Notice that this run still uses the older parameters, 60% up and 50% down. They make the game an ensemble average good game, but a time average bad game. Unfortunately, you and I both only live once. We cannot travel across multiverses to pick the realization where we get lucky. Can we survive the 50% down and 60% up game in our one and only one timeline? We can. Without a real ensemble, we can create our artificial players, I call them agents, to play on behalf of you. And you oversee the performances of this ensemble of agents. Here is how it works. We divide the initial $100 to $52 and assign them to artificial agents. Let them play the game with $2 initial money. Remember, there is no Brook mechanism now. We can then take advantage of the positive ensemble average. Most of the artificial agents will perform badly, but the few lucky ones should bring you a fortune. As the system of agents evolves, ultimately the few lucky green ones will dominate the system. Betting with them is almost equivalent to betting with the whole wealth. This leads to big fluctuations, as you can see. And as we proved earlier, if there is a Brook mechanism, as in real life, there is always a Brook mechanism, we are destined to go broke. We need to step in to control how much each agent owns. Although the agents play the game at the same time, each of them is not aware of the existence of others. Therefore, we can assign an order of playing without disturbing the nature of the game. When the first agent plays, we are effectively betting 2% of the total wealth. Although the artificial agent feels all in, the 50 all-ins by the agent ensemble is effectively a sequence of bets with changing bet size. We are heading to the derivation of the Kylie criterion, which states that there is an optimal bet size. However, I prefer to stay with the much more dramatic way. As the overseer of the system, you distribute your wealth equally to the artificial agents. Then let one artificial agent play the ensemble average good game, while all others play a dummy do nothing game. the net game is still an ensemble average good game. Then you optimize the total wealth across time by choosing the ensemble size. This unnecessarily dramatic perspective reveals something that the traditional Kelly criterion derivation doesn't show. A time average bad game can be transformed into a time average good game by introducing some kind of ensemble average. All remains is to find the right ensemble size. With an ensemble, the effect of winning or losing are both diluted by a factor of n. With our original game parameters, we want to maximize the geometric mean, which is the time average of our growth rate. We can visualize the function and find its maximum. It is very clear that a smaller ensemble makes the game a bad game, while a very large ensemble slows down the profit growing. The best performance is obtained when n equals 6. For general cases, we can derive the formula using calculus. At the very end, let me rerun the 5,000 player simulation. But this time, we bring back the Burk mechanism and we let everyone play by applying the Kelly criterion. No one is broke, and all three statistical measurements are close to each other. This video was inspired by several great videos on YouTube and a few interesting tweets, blogs, and papers. I linked all of them in the description. I hope you enjoy this video. I will see you in the next one. Prosper, you have 50% chance to have 10 trades and 50% chance to have 0 trades. Do you want to play the game? I just want one trade.